Mr. Sandeep Somani, the Senior Vice President of FICCI. Mr. Harish Mariwala. Sorry, Harsh, right? I'm sorry. Harsh Mariwala. Sachin and Jyoti. And ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to start my discussion today with an anecdote. There is a story of a young man who was traveling on a ship and he was standing on the deck outside having a fresh air and enjoying the cruise. There are a lot of people standing on the deck. Suddenly one lady jumped into the sea. Maybe by accident she fell or she jumped into the sea. So everybody was scared, what's happening? Then suddenly this young man also jumped into the sea and saved her. There was a lot of applause for him. And the entire ship, the cruise, they organized a grand party to felicitate him, saying that you've done a wonderful job. So everybody was praised for him. And then they asked him to speak. This is a Gujarati joke, so please pardon me if I first speak in Gujarati and then translate it into Hindi. So as soon as he got up to speak, he said, "E budhu to barabar che, pan mane e ko ke mane dhakko kone mairo." मुझे पुश किसने किया? ये सब ठीक है आप लोग जो मेरी प्रेज कर रहे हैं, बट ये बताओ मुझे पुश किसने किया था? वो सारा पुश भी इनसाइड है ना? I'd like to say that for all the bukas or brickbats of GST, these people are responsible. The business people made out a scene before the new government, as soon as the new government came, that either there is GST or there is no country. Either the country survives or it doesn't survive. And GST is a must. So much of importance everybody used to give that time. That country has been talking about it for 10 years. And unless you bring GST, no other reform is going to work in the country. This is the way all the people tried to tell the government at that time, as soon as the new government came. So obviously, this was a push given by them. We had no option but to plunge into it and do something. The government also showed a very firm political commitment to this reform. And as I mentioned the other day, when there is a high amount of political commitment combined with the bureaucratic zeal, the country can produce anything. And in spite of all the criticism of bureaucracy that all of you may be making, I must say one thing, that India's civil service is unparalleled. It is really unparalleled. It is because of the character of the civil service that, number one, we have remained integrated as a single country. And one more example of integration is happening in GST. Different states, different languages, different politics, different parties, but still the country as a whole has survived also because of the unifying factor of civil service. We civil servants, we work in different parts of the state most of our career, and then we also come to Government of India and make policies for the entire country. So this shuffle between state and the center, that is working. And secondly, the specialized services which we have created in the civil service, such as Indian Revenue Service, or Indian Trade Service, or Indian Legal Service. All these services are also playing a major role in doing their duties. So the bureaucracy is quite capable, and given the clear direction, they can deliver. This is an example of that. And so I would like to really say that the credit for GST reform goes to a lot of people, and I mentioned it on my on the occasion of the government function on the first year of GST, which we celebrated on Sunday, the last. And business people are also responsible for that. Number one, for pushing, and number two, for asking for a lot of changes in the tax structure. So for both this, they are responsible, and I think they have played their role very well. So let's compliment each other. That's all we can do today, since FICCI is also celebrating the first year of GST. And it's been a long journey of GST. But for us, last 2 years have been really crazy. It's been very, very crazy. Last 2 years, especially, you know, because we were trying to work out a strategy for pushing this through the parliament, the constitutional reform, right since April of 2016. Then finally it got passed in September or so of 2016. And we were then making the law, etc. Of course, law, etc., we had made earlier also. Even before the constitutional amendment was passed, the draft law was put in public domain after the Calcutta meeting of Empowered Committee, which was in April 16, if I remember. And since that, it was in discussion, the draft law, GST law. So it's not that all these laws are made in a day. They are made over a period of 5-6 years. A lot of officers, committee have gone into the drafting of various laws and rules. So it's been a long journey, but since we had to meet with certain deadline, we had to hurry up the whole process, and that's what we had to do. But my colleagues in the bureaucracy stood up to the occasion. They really rose to the occasion, and they played a marvelous role, and including the friends in GST. And somewhere I made a reference about technology failing us. But that does not mean that the people in GSTN failed us. There were some marvelous people who worked in GSTN. And in spite of their efforts, sometimes the technology still fails us. So like I gave an example, I may make a very good PowerPoint presentation to be made on this occasion, and suddenly the PowerPoint presentation does not open. It happens with technology. So that's what failed us. It's not that the people were lacking in their effort. What I'm saying is that our entire team, including GSTN team, we all tried to do our best to cope up with the situation. But still, some problems, whatever problems came, were mainly on account of technological issues. That's what we had to cope up. Human issues we solved quickly, and we modified. We were flexible enough to modify rules, notifications, whatever. But when it comes to technology, one has to bear with it, you know. If I tell the technology guys that I want this change in the software today, they'll say, sir, it'll take at least 8 weeks for us. Because making a small change in one column of a software will have so many other changes to be made which are incidental to it, that the software people will not be able to deliver me that kind of a thing, you know. So that's why it took us some little bit of problem. But otherwise, on the whole, I think it's been smooth. Look, there are two kinds of people. There are people who focus on positive, and there are people who always focus on negative. They will always talk about what is imperfect about this GST, rather than remember that what a change it has been. 17 different types of taxes, so many SACs, so much of compliance burden, different tax returns to be filed, cascading of taxation, everything going in one day, and also the border check post going away. Nobody, when GST is settled, we suddenly start thinking about what next and what should be. So we only focus on imperfection. This is a human nature. Ghar mein bhi agar kabhi achha khana bana hai, to we take it as granted. Kabhi wo to theek hai, banana hi hai. Agar achha nahi bana, us din phir mention hoga ki bhai khana kyun nahi achha bana hai. So like that, it's a human nature to focus on what is not there rather than what we have achieved. But we must remember that we have done a lot. We have actually gained quite a bit in the process of simplification by introducing GST. But that does not mean that there is no scope for betterment of the existing system. we still believe and we are convinced about it that yes, we need to do a lot more and we must work in that direction. And what are the areas of future improvement? All of you know now, because there has been so much of discussion about it. People have focused on it. So everybody is saying, simplify it further, have a perfect single GST return per month. Then your entire process of refund should be automated. It was meant to be automated right from day one. But unfortunately, people made so many mistakes in filing their forms, and we had to get into a manual mode at the last moment to at least not let their dues be pending with us. We wanted to clear the refund quickly. So we had to sort of move to the manual procedure also for some time. But we are again trying to make it completely automatic, the entire refund process, so that nobody has to go to anybody. No, nobody has to go to anybody to claim the refund. Now, this is the next direction that we are into. And in terms of simplification of rates, slabs, we do understand the need for it. But we did what was the best possible in the given scenario. We couldn't have done anything other than this, because we have to take care of revenue, we have to take care of the societal concerns of economically poor class, and we have to protect their products from taxation. So in the midst of all the imperfections that we have, we could do what was best possible. But yes, certainly we must move in the direction of something better than that. So this is all I wanted to say. I'd like to take a couple of questions if you want to ask, because I don't want to unnecessarily make long speeches. Questions probably might be better, since some of you are here, trade people. So yes, please.
Sir, one thing.